Hello, hello! Perfidious Pete here, back where it all began, ready to hoist a trembling, bleary-eyed celebrity warrior aloft to be anointed with fruit juice by a monkey in XCOM, The Long War 2. Oh man, just saying that last bit out loud gave me a real circle of life moment. This is where it all began for me, and now we've come back to that place, the Long War. We're back in it. It feels like Sir Elton John should be here right now, dropping a little dancing when ya nobody babado on us with the audio cue, but alas, he's nowhere to be found, and it's just me, my terrible voice, and my crew of celebrity warriors ready to get back to doing what we do best. Getting blown into haggis, fighting a hopeless campaign against a vastly superior foe and overwhelming odds while drowning in a tidal wave of salt. But before that wave of all-natural organic salt breaks overhead and pounds us into the reef like Nemo's dead mother, hey, let's check out the surf conditions and talk about our run a little bit. This is it. We're playing this sight unseen. I know absolutely zip bupkis about Long War 2. I have deliberately kept myself in the dark just like I did when XCOM 2 came out. So I'm working off of like no intel, no information, nothing. We're also working a brand new fresh installment with absolutely no mods at all installed other than the Long War 2. This is a pure Long War 2 run, no other modifications. I'm excited. So excited I can't even bring myself to not go. So let's just get started. Difficulty. Well, this may be a particularly stupid idea, but in order to maximize the chances of a 50-year storm level of salt, I'm going to just start on legendary. It's not recommended, I don't think, but you know what? That's okay. I don't really expect to be in this campaign the whole way anyhow. I'm approaching this one the way a starting quarterback for the Cleveland Browns approaches every game. I'm going in, expecting to lose, and just hoping not to wind up with a catastrophic traumatic brain injury before it's all over. That's really all I'm looking for. What about Iron Man mode, Pete? You gonna be going for Iron Man mode? Okay, well, I actually gave this little same thing about Iron Man mode a couple days ago when I recorded a series that was gonna be my new campaign, but then Long War 2 came out, and so you know what? Those are just gonna be the lost Perfidious Pete episodes of XCOM. But that's fine, I got a chance to recycle this speech. Didn't expect Long War 2 to come out so quickly. It kind of surfaced like Moby Dick on Captain Ahab just suddenly and biting off my leg. Which I suppose, you know, makes me Captain Ahab. But now, you know, I feel like I'm more of a Starbuck, but I digress. Let's get to the speech. Am I going to go with Iron Man mode? No, no Iron Man mode for Perfidious Pete. Pete, why not play on Iron Man? Well, I'm going to do an honest man run. We're not replaying any missions, and what you see is definitely what you're going to get. Like I said, I've lost on camera before. I don't care about losing on camera now, and I honestly expect to lose. It's probably what's going to happen. But what it boils down to, and this is true with any kind of game that you're modding the crap out of, any mod's going to introduce some stability issues, and crashes and problems are probably going to happen. They're going to be basically unavoidable. And when it comes to like lost footage, I'd really rather give you a complete episode than some stitched-together Frankenstein's monster of a beast that I had to crunch together in my editing software. When it comes down to just replaying a mission flat out or spending that same amount of time editing video, honestly, I'd rather just replay a mission. Because if you'd say, hey, Pete, you want to edit some video? Or, hey, Pete, you want to play some XCOM? I'm going to pick XCOM every single time. But that said, again, this is a full honest man run. You're going to see exactly the same thing I do. And unless the game crashes, there's no replays, no going backs, no restarts. One, because I am a profoundly lazy man. And two, I don't have that kind of time. I can't afford to replay missions over and over. I got to, you know, I'm a not that busy guy with stuff to do. But, you know, I do have a full-time job, regular working hours. Things of that nature, replaying missions, no, it's just not in the time budget. So let's do it. Let's start without Iron Man. We are going to enable all the DLCs. We'll get the Alien Hunters and Shen's Last Gift rocking in here as well. This is it, boys. Long War 2. Long wait is finally over. Now I can go back to being furiously salty when everything doesn't go my way because I'm an idiot. It's like a homecoming for me, really. Punishing my stupidity feels good, man. Feels good. 12 new gene therapy clinics will be open. What's our campaign theme for this one going to be while we talk about this and worry about, you know, all the cutscene here, which we've seen numerous times at this point. Well, just, well, you know, we got, I think this campaign's gonna be, it's gonna be a pretty dirty playthrough, and I really feel like we're gonna need a couple dozen dirty celebrities to get the job done for us. No, I'm not talking about Paul Ryan, although, you know, he isn't a politician, so probably dirty. Probably got some special interest money somewhere he's supposed to have. Yeah, I'm on to you. House Speaker. The bond with the elders can't be broken? That sounds a little creepy, actually. Once you've bonded with an elder, there is no escape. Oh, yeah, great. I'm like that, what if I want to break my bond with the elder? What if I don't, what if I want a divorce? Is this not allowed in Advent society? Is that it? It's like, once you've bonded with an elder, you're bonded forever till death do you part. It's not going to be the elder that dies, it's going to be you. Perfect. Radford, once again, perfect. He's talking about the hair. He knows it's perfect. He doesn't even have to check in a mirror at this point. Every single stitch of hair on that man's head, 100% perfectly coiffed. Bradford does not dick around when it comes to two things. There are two things Bradford takes more serious than a heart attack. One, gin. He takes his gin very seriously. Bathtub, brewed, homegrown, Bradford takes his gin seriously. The other thing, though, that hair. It's all about gin and the hair. As long as he's got a flask of gin in his pocket and that hair is 100% in place and on point, John Bradford doesn't care what Advent can throw at him. He knows he can take it. You're gonna regret that, punk. That's my gin-drinking stomach! Honestly, you know, as drunk as Bradford is right there, I'm surprised he didn't just yak all over that Advent trooper. That would have been the greatest thing he could have done, too. Just been like, oh, you're gonna punch me in the stomach? Well, I'm just gonna vomit on you. This is what happens when you punch a hideous drunk. You should have known better.
Signal received. Loud and clear. Okay, Gatecrasher. Your turn.
These two guys? Well, Gatecrasher, I hate to break it to you, but while you guys are doing this, Perfidious Pete's gonna be off doing the real mission. You two, you're the distraction. Sacrificial distraction, by the way. If you were in Jurassic Park, you would be the goat that got chained in the T-Rex bin that Wayne Knight sent up to get horribly, grisly dismembered. You guys, you're that goat. Let's just hope I'm not the lawyer who decided to hide in the toilet. This is new. This is literally the first time I've booted up again. Oh, please tell me it didn't crash. Okay, good. All right. So we're going to Ghost Alley, Chicago. Here's our team of celebrity badasses. And I said we were going to get dirty on this one. We're going to get dirty. The dirtier, the better. As dirty as you can possibly imagine. We got some folks who know how to hit below the belt. It's going to be dirty. It's the dirty. When you got a suicide mission, and let's face it, this run really probably is in all likelihood a suicide mission. I don't expect to succeed on this. I would be unbelievably shocked if this campaign went the distance. Even if we went the distance and lost, I would just be flabbergasted. But who do you send on a suicide mission? You send the Expendables. You get your Lee Marvin. You get your Jim Brown. You get yourself a Dirty Dozen. And that's what Perfidious Pete has got himself. I've got my very own Dirty, Dirty Dozen ready to take the field here. So without any further ado, let's do it. Hell yeah. I don't know why it says press any key, but I always hover over that bar and click it like it's some kind of action bar rather than just waiting for any input. So Pete, who's the Dirty Dozen? Well, we don't have a full dozen here. Ambush enemy troops. Okay. Advent typically moves its forces in large groups. We've located a small unit on its own that is vulnerable. A well-timed assault will damage Advent's interest in this region and afford us a rare opportunity to bring home enemy corpses for research. So, who's on the Dirty Dozen? Well, you can see we got OJ Musta Quit Simpson, followed by Tim Cokey Smurf Allen. We got Matthew Hit and Run Broderick on the team. We got Bill, allegedly, Cosby. Then we got Tanya Masterplan Harding, we got Jay Stabs a Lot Z, Phil the Spectre Spectre, and Matthew Joker McConaughey. Is that it? Alright then. This is the team, folks. I told you we were getting dirty and we got the dirtiest of dirty on our side. Neutralize all enemy targets, so this is just a kill mission then. We are concealed, which is good. Alright, let's start looking around and looking for some enemies then. We started with way more than four guys. We got one. How many guys do we got? We have seven people on this. I'm already sort of terrified by the fact that we have seven people on a mission. That seems like way too many. Why are you giving me seven for Gatecrasher? Normally you do it with four. Do we want to try and stretch a little bit? How big is this map? Okay, we got some civilians over there for... Oh, you know what we need to do? We need to get to this road tile. We definitely want the elevation advantage. Let's start heading in that direction. We got to get up there on that elevated railway. I need the height advantage. We're going to take some yellow moves here because these should be safe. We will probably wind up going on Overwatch just in case the enemy wanders into us or something and springs our trap. Well, it won't really be a trap, but busts our concealment. Phil Spectre, Spectre. This is one thing XCOM 2 does not do exceptionally well, I would like to point out. When you have more than, say, six guys, sometimes the way it cycles through them is a little bit wonky. And by a little bit wonky, I mean actually a lot wonky. Also, as a notice, we have no mission timer here. So we can take as much time as we want. I guess it is like Operation Gatecrasher. We got a freebie on this first one. So let's just take it slow and steady then. Phil Spectre, Spectre, why don't you ghost your way forward and see if you can actually find us a bad guy? Or alternatively, ghost your way forward and see if you can get us onto this rooftop where we're going to have huge aim bonuses at anything we decide to shoot. Okay, we're just, we're going to play it tight. Gonna, you know, aim small, miss small. Coming at this with the classic Mel Gibson method. Possibly even that Mel Gibson might make an appearance in this run. I mean, it's not out of the question. He definitely fits the bill. Basically, the bill is, you know, any celebrity with a record. That's what we're looking at here. Had a run-in with the law or two? Is that what it is, Matthew Joker Smurf? Actually, sorry, Tim is Cokie Smurf. You're Matthew Joker McConaughey. You know, he's a joker, he's a toker, he's a midnight smoker. Alright. We got some aliens over here, Pete. Looks like we about to have ourselves a damn hell of a good time. Alright, so OJ, let's get you up here. I really would prefer OJ not spot the enemy. All I really want him to do is get up on top of this thing. Are you going to go up this turn, Pete? Nope, I'm not going up until the first man up is still on a blue move, so we have every opportunity to react. Remember, this is the long war, man. We played enough long war the first time to know that you don't... this game, it punishes the shit out of aggression. Aggression will be punished, and it will be punished severely. You will be sent to jail. You will not pass go. You will not collect $200. You report straight to the office, young man. That's it. You're going on detention, Pete. Do not be aggressive. We just can't do it. Not even when we got Phil the Spectre Spectre on our side, and we afford to be aggressive. This is not a high school football game. We can't be aggressive, B-E aggressive. We can't B-E-A-G-G-R-E-S-S-I-E-B-E. We can't do it. Understood. Pete, were you a cheerleader in high school? That sounded pretty good. You know, no, I wasn't, but hung out with some. Still nothing. All right, somebody's going up top. OJ? The hell with it. Oh, we have multiple grenades again? We have a frag grenade and a flashbang. Why do I have two grenades? So it's back to classic long war then with multiple grenades of multiple types for each unit. And we still have no vision on the enemy, huh? All right, well, this is, certainly taking its sweet-ass time. Still, I'm coming up here. I want the aim bonuses. I don't care. If we got to take our time, play tight, play conservative, get the elevated position and the extra hit bonuses. We are still concealed, too, by the way. I may be playing a little cautiously, but the long war has got... It's just... The original long war has beaten caution into my brain. Caution is the watchword. You always played cautious in the original long war because the second you got aggressive... Some alien was going to come put a foot up your ass or down your throat or in your ear. It was definitely going to connect a foot with some orifice you may or may not want to have a foot connected with. You know, if you're into foot in the butthole, I mean, I'm not judging anybody. Love what you love, dog. I'm just saying. The long war ain't going to go gentle with it. They're not going to use appropriate amounts of lube and caution. No. It's going to be a violent foot in assholey. We still got nothing. All right. Overwatch anybody who's left. Yeah, we've been hearing those same aliens for like 25 minutes, but apparently they just don't want to come to the party, man. They know we brought seven guys, and they're like, holy shit, man, they got seven guys for Gatecrasher. It seems like ridiculous overkill. Well, we're spotted. All right, what do we got? Two regular advent, couple drones. This is one of the reasons why we wanted to do this with our first guy. We got an officer. And the drone is actually going to be a bit of a problem. So we got a 72% shot at the drone. 31%? Wow. Okay. So high cover is a serious advantage. 29% for that guy. 27 there. So we have shots at effectively the drone and nothing else. That is somewhat unfortunate. Can we get... I mean, we could come over here and get... Is this going to be a flank shot? That should be a flank shot on the officer. Do we want to risk dropping down for a flanker? We're like on the edge of the map, right? Yeah, I don't really think there's any chance, or much of a chance, rather, that this spawns a new pod. Let's give it a shot here.
Understood. Moving out.
Let's drop him down, see if we can get the flank. Also, we should see how big our grenades are, actually. Okay, standard 3x3 tile. Got it. So only a 70% even with the flanker. Wow. All right. Well, let's take the shot. Broderick, what do you got? He's got the hit. Matthew, hit and run. Now run, Broderick. It's in the name, dude. You're the hit and run, man. You hit him. Now run. This is your paradigm. First you hit, then you run. All right. We got the cause. Master plan. Is anybody going to be able to get a shot on that guy in the building? It kind of seems like not really. Phil Spector? Nope. Can we get rid of that cover then? It feels like this may be a pretty good opportunity. All right, let's see what kind. I know there have been some changes to grenades. That's one thing I was like not able to avoid a spoiler, and that they don't quite do as much as they used to when it comes to cover destruction. But it seems like their base damage has been increased. They can do up to 5 now? Interesting. That did nothing. It did not destroy his cover, and it did no damage. It did no damage. Well, that's, all right. Interesting. That's a real kind of kick in the dick hole. Is this going to be a flank shot? We can get some quality flankers here. We got a lot of flanks lined up. Okay. Let's come up here. We do still need to get 2 damage on that officer. We have 1 flank shot, 85%. Let's take it. Jay stabs a lot. Z? Oh, he didn't get stabby, but he got shooty, and shooty turns out to have been good enough. If we can get that officer down, then I just want to work over the robot. We can definitely get the officer if we just have the Joker drop down here. He should have a point blank flank. Hey, all right, Pete. A point blank flank. That's just the way old Matty. You gotta be fucking kidding me. Love the 86% chance miss. That's a fantastic way to start. So how many people we got left? We got Phil the Spectre. All right, OJ. I mean, that guy in the building is going to be basically untouched, and I don't know what we can do about it. We can probably... Are we going to be able to kill the... I'm a little concerned about being able to kill the robot, actually. All right, Philly D, let's get you up here. We got to get rid of some of this armor. I wonder, do frag grenades still shred armor, I suppose? We could have Phil shoot, but really I would rather get rid of some of that armor and get a little guaranteed damage here. We got 1, but we did shred. 1 stopped on the armor. We shredded 1. So we got 3 units left. We still got to kill. Somebody's got to do something about Cuba. Could anybody? Okay, only OJ could get a flank, but if he does it, he's going to be completely out of cover. That's horrible. Let's take our other 2 units then and see if we can get... I don't want to group up because I'm afraid of getting grenaded. I want everybody at least separated by 1 tile. I have a feeling like the enemies are going to be in a long war very inclined. Oh, good God. 63% chance to hit this guy? We did. Okay. Wait, that thing has dodge? I'm not liking this at all. The aliens seem just ludicrously powerful. We had a guy standing, he just stood on top of a grenade. We got nothing at all out of it. All right, oh, well, if grenades are useless, then we might as well just take advantage of this. We're going to kill this man with a grenade. Since Matthew McConaughey couldn't get the friggin' job done. Can we get 2? Alright, we got 3 damage out of that. We destroyed loot. Well, you know what? That's gonna happen. And that just leaves us with the Kaz, who I guess we're gonna bring up here and see if he can get 3 damage on this drone. He'll be lucky if he can even hit it. 61% is so bad. You know what? Screw it. No risk. No risk, no reward. Go drone. And we are back in a long war, so we should be thinking about maybe not blowing up loot. We did kill a surveillance drone. It did not leave a corpse. All right, so we got to worry about using, once again, using explosives is just a terrible idea. This guy ran and activated another pod immediately. Well, that's very bad. On the plus side, area suppression. What the hell is this? So he is suppressing who? Or rather, whom? Because, you know, objective case, Pete. Come on, you have a... So 3 of our people are suppressed by that? This one guy has 3 of my guys suppressed, and none of them can hit him. Well, that's feeling like straight-up rock and horse shit right there. Grenades have a... Oh. Now I get it. Grenades have a cooldown. They're not a consumable, they have a cooldown. Very interesting. All right, Jay-Z, let's see if we can pull a little long war trick here. If we bring you down here and have you chuck the flasher, will that knock this guy out of suppression? It damn well better is all I'm going to say. Can we catch anybody else with it? We're only going to get this guy. You know what? Feels worth it. This better take him out of suppression or I'm going to be supremely pissed off. We got him. All right. He's disoriented and we have removed his overwatch. Good work, Jay-Z. Jay-Z, he's down there dropping the dope rhymes. Ugh, this is... Still, though, we have the height advantage and I still feel not good because we also only have half cover. These guys are active. I would actually feel more comfortable if maybe we fell back. We don't have a turn timer here. That's the thing. We got to remember, no turn timer. Maybe we go back to classic long war strats, which I don't love having to go back to classic long war strats because it makes missions take forever and by and large, just a bunch of big, boring Overwatch camp fest. But are we going to be able to see this guy from here? Can't really tell. The game says, like, no. Let's just back up a little bit. Do we have vision? We do not. All right, you're going to be on Overwatch then. We're going to take some advantages, try and get some height advantage Overwatch working here. Jay-Z's in a little trouble, though, because he's visible to a couple enemies, and he's going to have no defense. Well, there's no reason to shoot at this guy, because we are never going to hit him. Do we have anybody who could get up here and chuck a grenade? You know, if we come over here, we would be standing in the open, but we might be able to hit that tile with a grenade. Game says we can't actually see anyone from this tile, which means, likewise, they should be invisible to us. Or we should rather be invisible to them. Of course, that also means we can't throw a grenade out there. Come on, get it out there. Come on, don't, XCOM, don't start this shit already. You're already making me want to install the grenade mod that lets you throw grenades where they actually need to go, rather than snapping them to a tile. See, because we had it for like a split second. There. So grenades aren't consumables, they just have a 2-turn cooldown. There we go, we got some damage there, and now we got potential flank shots here for Koki Smurf. Much better flankers. All right, Koki, we may have you move in a minute. If Phil the Spectre can kill this Advent Gunner, nobody's gonna have vision on us. There it is! Phil the Spectre puts him down! Alright, so Koki Smurf, the game says, if we back up one square, you can't be seen. Or rather, is that true? That is in fact true. Alright then, you're on Overwatch. Matthew, I am not gonna have you in half cover. The long war taught us too many hard lessons about what it means to be in half cover, and usually what being in half cover means is your ass is toast. You're gonna be dead. Hog food on a stick, baby. That's what it means. We're not on a turn timer here. Let's take the appropriate precautions, use height to our advantage, and try and get... Oh, shit. Okay, all right. Trading fire and mist. I really am missing perfect information right now. Gonna shoot at the same guy? Okay, what's protected mean? He panicked. What the hell does protection mean, though? He hunkered down. Why did these guys not get Overwatch? That guy moved, fired, and went on Overwatch? What bullshit is that? How do you get a move, shoot, and go on Overwatch? Alright, well, I mean, he's on Overwatch, which is a significant problem for us. How are we supposed... Okay, let's assume that there's a turn timer on this mission. What the shit would we supposed to be doing right now? That would be my question. How would we ever... This would be largely insurmountable. This guy moved, fired, and went on Overwatch all in the same turn. That seems real bullshitty. The only person who has... Well, I can flashbang only the man with Overwatch and get nobody else. And you know what? I'm going to do it. I don't care. If these are not consumables, but are in fact on turn timers, we're going to be using a lot of grenades. And specifically, we're going to be using like a lot of flashbangs and whatnot. So master plan, we can get you up here for a flank shot, right? You should definitely have a flank shot at that sentry. And good, because I don't like that guy even a tiny little bit. Move shoots Overwatches in the same turn? That seems like some extraordinarily level, like, big... You gotta be fucking shitting me. Another pod? Alright, well, I guess every mission of the Long War is gonna be 690 hours long. So we gotta take a shot at this sentry. Our team is way too... And we missed. Perfect. ...41%, 40%. We have effectively no chance to hit any of these guys. And once again, it just feels like the right move here is to fall back again. Also, this mission is going to take 8 trillion years to play if we play like this. This whole... Am I already getting salty at the Long War? Pete, you're not... I mean, you're not even one full mission in it, and you're already sounding super salty. Yeah, you know what? I'm kind of feeling a little salty, I'm not going to lie. Because, yeah, we're only one mission in, but here's the thing. This already feels like everything I hated about the original Long War. It's impossible to go forward. It's impossible to be aggressive. All you got to do is just sit down, hunker down, put your head between your legs, and just pray the enemy never hits you. Meanwhile, keep throwing flashbangs at people while you hunker down and try and get them to walk into some helpless Overwatch. We have, like, no shots whatsoever. And our best plan is still to take our terrible, terrible shots and try and kill somebody with an Overwatch hit. We have a 30% chance to hit that advanced sentry. Boy, that's perfect. We've got guys in half cover, but most of the enemies in our defense have been flashbanged. We have a 66% chance for a flanker or 66 on the... I'm really worried about this. You know what? I'm going to take the engineer shot. Oh, good. We never hit anything. That's fantastic. The fact that we have that man flanked, though, should encourage him to move. OJ? I mean, we could bring you up here and have you spam a flashbang, too. Why not? Let's just... Hell, screw it. Let's just flash the whole universe. Hey, baby, you want to see what Pete's got under the coat? Yeah, it turns out it's my dong. Here it comes. Actually, does that flashbang get us anything? No, because everybody it's going to hit is already flashed. So that flashbang is pointless. We'd be better off to take the ghetto shot. Or alternatively, just, you know what? No, we're not going to take any ghetto shots. We're just going to go on Overwatch. We got disoriented guys down there in cover. Let's see how they react. Some of them are flanked and they are on Overwatch. Mind spin? Okay. Tanya Harding is panicked. Honestly, I don't mind if she hunkers down. That's fine. I really miss my perfect information. I would love to know what these guys' shot percentages are like. Took an Overwatch shot and missed. Took an Overwatch shot. We can't hit anything. The enemy's not hitting us either, but remember, their entire unit is flashbanged. Like, every single one of them is just horrifically disoriented at the moment. Somebody hit... You gotta be fucking shitting me. At 20% hit chances, we should have connected once by now, statistically. Somebody should have hit something. All right, well, Tanya Harding is panicked. O.J. Simpson is not panicked, and the entire enemy team, once again, is about to be flashbanged because this is all we can do. We can't actually hit anyone to injure them, so why bother trying? Oh, I'm getting real salty. Also, we can't really land a flat. Here we go. Come on. God damn it. I really miss the mod that made targeting with grenades actually doable instead of this stupid snap shit. It won't even stay in this tile for like more than a second. I hate tile snapping. Oh good, it disoriented one guy. Well, that was a good use of our time, wasn't it? So what do you got for shots? You have a 41% and a 41%, and those are both terrible. On the plus side, the Joker's got some flankers here. Let's bring you up to this full cover. Even if he hits, though, he's not going to kill anyone. His best hit is 66%. That's the... You know what? No. Can we catch two people with a grenade? Nope. Toss it around the corner, Joker. Well, we did manage to expose that man, so maybe he's not in full cover anymore. Maybe somebody else has a decent shot at him, stabs a lot with the 41 and a 41. We're going to have to explode our way through this mission, I feel like. It almost feels like it's the only thing we can do. I don't like doing it, but I don't see any other options whatsoever. We can't hit anything. Our aim penalties are just so egregious. 61% on an enemy we have flanked? Seems remarkably low. We got 4 damage out of that grenade. See, what we should do now that we've got some guys in here and we have damage on them, that's definitely going to be a flank shot. What we should do is try and finish them off with a bullet so we don't have to kill them with exclusively explosive. 60% chance to hit? I don't understand how this is supposed... Like, none of these enemies are actually killable, though. When we do manage to hit them, every hit is a friggin' graze. We can hit the enemy, but we can't actually do any kind of significant damage to them whatsoever. We can't destroy their cover to give ourselves decent chances to hit. We have a 20%. It feels like I'm playing with one hand tied behind my back. Also, this mission, we're like 40 minutes in on this already. Are we just going to sit here and take terrible reaction shots? Or are we just supposed to gamble on bad? Is that what we're supposed to do? Just gamble on bad shots and hope they hit? Because that seems like a terrible, terrible strategy. I want that Grenadier dead because I'm afraid he's going to launch grenades at me. Can anybody hit him? It says 42%, but it really doesn't feel like 42. We have 7 men on that team. The entire team went, and all of them combined to do exactly fuck all. It also seems like the enemy has difficulty hitting us, but then again, we do have them flashbanged all the holy bejesus. Once again, we have missed. Overwatch is pointless. Trying to shoot through a car. This so far seems manageable. What we've got thus far, the actual gunfight part seems, like, reasonable. The thing that has me concerned, what if we had a turn timer here? That guy moved, shot, and still went on Overwatch. If we're on a turn timer here, I really honestly don't see how this would ever be achievable. Without unlimited time to do this, we would have effectively zero chance of accomplishing anything. Just nothing at all. So we've got to flashbang everybody again because it seems to be the only thing that has any kind of chance of keeping everyone alive. So let's just drop that down there. Tanya master plan Harding, hitting them with the flash in a pan to keep them grazed. Tim Allen's going to reload. He has vision on 2 enemies, no flank shots, which means I'm assuming his hit chances are basically zero. Yeah, they're basically zero. Do we have anybody who can drop a grenade on this sentry? Anybody. Any kind of grenade whatsoever. We have a flashbang. Or we have hit and run here. Well, alright then. I mean, It's working so far. I guess if we just keep the entire enemy team disoriented for all of eternity, we'll eventually be able to get him. So his Overwatch is done. Cosby, can you get above that man and shoot him in the back of the skull? The answer is no. Well, it wouldn't matter even if we got you up there and you did get a shot at the back of his skull. You wouldn't be able to hit it anyway. Yeah, we should have... We can't... How can we not see this man below us? I was expecting this to produce a flank shot on this man because clearly this is not a flank shot. We've got him from behind at an elevated position, and yet still, we got nothing. Jay-Z, can we get you a flank? Okay, we can get Jay-Z a flank shot, but he is then going to, in turn, also be flanked. We could bring Jay-Z to here, but one of these guys is going to run around and shoot him. I don't think we can probably afford to give the enemy flank shots. Is there any decent cover in here? We cannot have Matthew McConaughey not in full cover. We can't do anything that's going to give... Okay, well... I hate to do this, but we're like 40 minutes into this, and this mission doesn't even seem close to over. I'm tempted to maybe put in a cut. I hate to cut. Can I afford to cut in the first? No, you know, we got to play this one through. We may be looking at like a 6.5 hour episode, but we got to play through the first episode at a minimum. Get a 45% chance to hit this guy. The hit penalties here are just... I don't know. Maybe legendary is not just a bad idea. Maybe it's an objectively horrific idea. Going in here is suicide. That's just going to put us in a position where we've got a bunch of guys who can take shots at us through half cover. And I feel like full cover and flashbangs are the only thing keeping us safe. Can anybody shoot this fucking sentry? How is he goddamn invisible right there? Even if we come down here and take this flank shot, we're probably just gonna miss. That's my concern. What if we just miss? Well, we gotta take a chance at some point. All right, Cokie Smurf, get your ass down here. Please don't miss. It's a 78% shot. Ordinarily, we would expect to hit... Oh, okay, so we get a pointless 6 damage critical. All right. Yeah, your weapon's spent. That's gonna happen. All right, stabs a lot. How come you can not go over... No. You know what? You're in full cover and you have vision on a couple of the enemy. I think we're just going to put you on Overwatch. We're overwatching from elevated positions and still getting jack out of it. McConaughey has not moved and I don't really feel inclined to move him. I think we're just going to have him bunker in at Overwatch. See, put like a, even if you put like a 20 turn timer on this mission, it still feels pretty undoable. Cosby, can you get anything? Nope. So you're just going to be on Overwatch as well. I'm feeling like, man, we're probably just going to overwatch around the horn. This is exciting combat, folks. Gripping gameplay right here. Watch as we hunker down on Overwatch against a bunch of foes who've been flashbanged 50 times. Was that a hit? Okay. Protected, and then it said damaged to. I don't know what that means. Eventually, somebody will hit an Overwatch shot. No, no. We've missed that guy like four. We've shot that man so many times, he had to freaking reload. This guy also had to freaking reload. Unbelievable. Well, at least we got the guy who gets to move and Overwatch dead. The flashbangs really are the only thing that's keeping us in this. Well, okay, so what's the lesson then, Pete? If the flashbangs are the only thing keeping you in it, the lesson is keep flashbangs ready because you're going to need them. I feel like the elevated position may be one of the other things that's keeping us in this. So this should get us a definitive flank shot. From an flanked from an elevated position, and we're still 71%. Either rookies are just hot, flaming, sweaty garbage, or the penalties here are a little too extreme. So who's got a flashbang? Because we're going to need like 6 of them. Oh, you can run out of grenades, apparently. Wait, are grenades both consumables... And have a cool... Are they consumable and have a cooldown? They're consumables and they have a cooldown. Oh my god, that's horrible. Oh, we can see everybody from up here, but that's possibly the worst position we could ever occupy. So Tim Allen does have...
Orders confirmed. Move
He's gonna have to come in here with no ammo and throw a flashbang so that we can keep all of our team safe. On the plus side, we will be flashbanging all these enemies with this, so we're gonna catch them all. It's a Pokemon-style flashbang. Gonna catch them all. Throw it right there in that pile of garbage, Tim. Flashbang the trash. Flash the trash. Hashtag flash the trash. And then I guess we just advance and take ghetto shots? Is that what the paradigm is? Advance for ghetto shots? I mean, Jay-Z here doesn't even have a bullet, so having him do anything at all other than move to cover seems monumentally stupid. Matthew hit and run Broderick. He can't even see the enemy. Anything from here? He has one, I'm going to guess, terrible shot. Yeah, that's not even worth taking, actually. We could hunker down, I suppose, but that guy is flashbanged. We don't have a... Yeah, you know what? No, we're not going to overwatch for that terrible shot. In fact, Matthew Broderick, start running around over here. Maybe we can get around these guys or flank them or maybe get on top of their rooftop and do some flanking from over there. We got to start making some moves, man. We've been in this mission for a goddamn eternity and we have accomplished nothing other than trading fire with guys we can't hit. There's a 66% on the flank. I'm taking it. I can't believe we actually hit an enemy and they didn't dodge or graze or do something else that otherwise mitigated the damage. I am flabbergasted. All right, Phil the Spectre. Spectre, you're coming up here. We need to start getting around behind these guys. We can try and pin them in place maybe with a little bit of good overwatch. Let's get a little closer here for OJ. OJ's going to have... He has bad shots. Let's just put him on overwatch. If his 36% is the best he's going to do, there's no reason to start taking these shots. We got to try and envelop these guys. This is going to be our only hope. Overwatch, there's a whiff. Man, I'm really missing perfect information right now. Okay. So that's all the enemies that are active. So the question then becomes, do we get super aggressive and go in for the kill, or do we play it more conservatively? Tim Allen's got to reload. There you go. And since he's not going to be able to also move and do anything, I think we're just going to put Tim on overwatch. If we bring you around over here, you will have corner full cover, but you also have you have a grenade. One of those guys is on... Okay, that guy is on overwatch, though. Can we do anything about the overwatch? Tanya Harding's got to reload to get anything. Can you take a shot at that guy with overwatch? You can see him, but you're never going to hit him. 1 in 5 to hit him? That's just terrible. Jay-Z's got to reload. Jay-Z, can you do any better on the guy with the overwatch? You know what? Take the shot. It missed. This is not surprising to anyone. We could do some really great stuff if Tim Allen could just get in here without getting shot at. Oh, wait a minute. At no point during this run can that guy even see Tim Allen? The game says he won't even be visible. He isn't... Okay, never... Well, you completely wasted... We wasted some perfectly good bullets right there. There was nothing wrong with those bullets, and we have squandered them. So this is going to do nothing then? I don't understand how cover works in the... Like, cover destruction isn't really a thing, apparently. Also, normally this would just hit this guy for damage, which is really all I want. It did not do that, and it did not remove his overwatch. It did exactly nothing. Did that do literally nothing? Okay, well, grenades are pointless then. I guess there's no reason to buy, purchase, or equip them. Alright, so where's my Phil Spectre? Spectre, if we bring you around here... You should not take overwatch with this move. And he did not. Flank shot of an advent trooper, sectoid. I'm not taking a 27. You know what? I will take this 76% chance. Come on, Spectre, make him a ghost! Well, Phil Spectre at least put a hit on him, so that's something. The Kaz can't really do much of anything. You know what, Cosby? We're going to bring you up here to where Phil Spectre was. You can't do anything this turn. You're going to have to try and come up with something next turn. Master plan, I think we're just going to drop you into overwatch. McConaughey? I think we just overwatch. This is so unsatisfying. We're just going to sit here and overwatch back. Oh, good God, we're fucked. Their disorientation is removed. So that guy's just straight up went onto overwatch. The sectoid's going to mind spin. Tim Allen is disoriented, which means he's not going to be able to hit anything. This guy's going to hopefully get killed? No, because Overwatch just doesn't work. Well, it took three people, but we finally got him. How is this supposed to be possible with a turn timer? It just seems literally impossible. This guy, again, has put himself on Overwatch. Phil Spector Spector should still have flank shots at these guys as soon as he gets some bullets in his gun.
It's killing time.
Yeah, it's killing time, all right. Oh, fantastic. You have a 27% chance to hit that, man. What good is there of putting loot down there, by the way, when the loot isn't always irretrievable? The geometry of this device is irritating me. Well, Matthew McConaughey has no bullets in his gun, and he can't do anything from where he's at, and we might be able to get some mileage out of this flashbang. So let's send it up and over. We can knock this guy out of Overwatch. I think we just try and bum rush him. I would kill for someone who had some freaking melee right now. Tim Allen can't do anything because he's disoriented, so his movement has been basically disabled. We're not going to be able to get a shot from anywhere decent over here. I mean, we'll have a shot. It'll just be a terrible one. Cosby? I mean, we could get you over here for what should definitely be at least a flank shot, right? How is this enemy not flanked? That's what I would like to know. How is that not a flank shot? Well, this'll damn well better be a flank shot. Also, we're going to pick up some loot here for Tanya Harding, who is injured, by the way. An advanced suppressor. Okay, no idea what a suppressor does. These are also not flank shots. Yeah, it's pretty much all we can do. It's this game is called Eternal Overwatch. So we've learned one very important lesson, and that lesson is that the most valuable build you could possibly build in XCOM The Long War is going to be any sort of Overwatch build. 27% chance to hit. It's Overwatch here. On the plus side, we are going to put in a position where these guys are just going to be literally unable to move. They're flashbanged and surrounded. This game, this has been like 25 turns. I just don't see this particular mindset or design philosophy working. I don't see it working with a turn timer. Any flank shots? Nope. 45% is the best we can do. These guys should try and move though, because they are still flanked, and unless they've drastically changed the AI. The AI response to being... never mind, they're not flanked because this thing has bizarre cover, which is why they're all huddled down in it. Taking shots at the badly injured Tanya Harding. Okay, then. Tim Allen is... okay, this has to be a flank shot? This can't not be a flank shot. This cover makes fuck all sense, people! That's it. I've had enough of this. How are they not flanked? How is that not a flank shot? I want gotcha. I want my gotcha mod back for exactly crap like this where you've got non-intuitive geometry. That's why I want my flank modification back. And you know what other mod I want back? I want perfect information back. I want to know what kind of hits percentage chances these guys have. 76%. We might generate a kill if we get luckier than average with damage. Holy shit, we killed another guy. Well, it took 40 minutes, but we finally got there, chat. We did it. We did it, Reddit. This should also be a flank shot? It almost can't not be. It's a 65% flank shot, and honestly, I feel like we'd be... well, you know what? It ain't getting any better. We might as well just start shooting. Good shot, Cosby! I'd try to be more salty about you, Cosby, but the fact that that was indeed a 65% chance to hit, you know what? I don't. What are you gonna do, Cos? Connie Harding is just gonna hunker down here, actually. Dig it in. JZ, I think we're gonna have you go on Overwatch, and Phil Spector Spector, also Overwatch. McConaughey, why don't you get some bullets in your gun? And you do have a grenade that maybe can't be useful this turn, but perhaps next turn might produce some results for us. It should be able to blow up a bag of garbage, I hope. OJ has a not flank shot, so we're just going to put him on Overwatch. I'm curious just to see how this guy reacts. I want to see what he does. He's completely pinned down in a cul-de-sac. He's going to run. Hit once. Our entire team is on Overwatch here. Graze, graze, miss, graze, dodge. Oh, good. And we took some... All right. Well, we took some damage, but on the plus side, we're definitely going to get the kill here, even if everybody just walks up and puts a gun in this sectoid's mouth. And I almost... I'm praying that this is, like, the last enemies on the map. My real fear is, what if there are more guys? If there are more guys, we may definitively have to put a cut in. Please be end of mission. This was Operation Gatecrasher. Alright, so 52 minutes in, we've got Operation Gatecrasher taken care of and some promotions earned. Fan-friggin-tastic. Well, this was, I don't know about you, but I really thoroughly, I mean, the tidal wave of salt has already begun, because this mission felt real fun, didn't it? Teeny tiny creeping around in a protracted 75-turn gun battle. Our successful shot percentage was 61%, despite the fact that I think we maybe took three shots that were below 65%. Average damage per attack, 1.43. Our average damage per attack was half the minimum of our gun. That seems problematic. On the plus side, Tanya Harding got shot three times. Maybe I'm thinking of this the wrong way. Maybe you're supposed to have troopers who get shot but don't die? Maybe this isn't like the original Long War, where if you got hit once, you just straight up were dead. That was it. There was no coming back. Any shot was fatal. Maybe that's the problem I'm running into. Maybe I'm playing too conservative, thinking, if we get shot, we will die. Perhaps that getting shot and this is not the end of the world. Maybe it has reduced wound timers or something? I mean, there are a couple different ways this could work. We had seven people on that mission, and I felt just hideously undergunned, I'm not gonna lie. But hey, promotions, so let's see what's the master plan. Tiny Master Plan Harding is a heavy weapon. This soldier is trained to use the XCOM gauntlet, a combination rocket and flamethrower. Alright, cool, I guess. So Tanya Harding bringing in the crowbar early. Matthew hit and run Broderick also got hurt. 13 days on the wound timer, I don't know if that's a lot or not. Why is his mobility minus 4? Matthew Hit-and-Run Broderick is a grenadier. Why is your mobility minus 4? Is that because of the wound? OJ must equip. Simpson has minus 3 mobility. It must be because of equipment. All right, and OJ is a ranger. Got light him up. Oh, man, I was really hoping OJ would be a shinobi. It just would stand to the melee would be a thing that he could do. Tim Cokie Smurf Allen's going to get all hopped up on the goofballs and go start knifing people. He's take... Oh, OJ... Tim Allen, you better watch yourself in the shower, man. You just stole OJ's bit. He's gonna fucking ruin you. Bill Alleged Cosby is our specialist. Well, if there's one thing the man knows how to do, it's slip you a Mickey Finn. He knows how to get in and get out undetected, am I right? Oh, that was not fucking funny, Pete. That was not funny at all. So we got Jay Stabs a Lot Z, who is a sharpshooter. Intriguing. Okay, and then we have two guys in the back. Wait, we had 8 people on that mission. Pete, you can't even count the number of your own troopers. How the hell did you get out of this with nobody dead? I have no idea. An abundance of camping, I guess? So Phil Spectre's going to be making some Spectres as our heavy. He's got area suppression, which means Matthew McConaughey's our shinobi.
All right. You know me, Pete. I'm slipping in, slipping out undetected. Just like when old Rust Cole was trying to take down the king in yellow. Yeah, that's right, Pete. I'm your boy.
So, what do we pick up? 25 supplies, 3 Illyrium crystals, some alloys, a sectoid corpse, 1 Advent, 7 Advent trooper corpses. We also picked up an advanced suppressor. Significantly reduces a soldier's impact on mission infiltration time. I have no idea what that means, but it sounds useful. We also have an Illyrium core. And it's where we're going to wrap this up. We got a ton of other stuff to do, but I'm going to do that, I think, at the opening of next episode, because this one is like an hour long already. If you enjoyed it, feel free to drop a like down in the comment section. Support really does mean a lot. If you'd like to see more Long War 2, you might consider subscribing as well. Post new episodes every single day right now. You know, I'm salty as hell, but it actually feels good to be back. I'm salty as hell, but the salt feels oh so right. It feels oh so right. Thanks very much for watching. I'll see you again soon.